In the first two lessons on inequality, we found the inequality of fractions by just thinking about the meaning of fraction symbols. For example, 1/10 is less than 1/3 because if you cut something into 10 equal parts, the parts are smaller than if you cut it into 3 equal parts. These special cases of fractions encourage students to think about the meaning of fraction symbols and to make quick decisions. In this final lesson on inequality, we will develop a test for determining the inequality of any two fractions. Let's begin by finding an inequality for 7/10 and 2/3. Now we can see from these bars that 7/10 is a little bit greater than 2/3. But we're not always going to have fraction bars to determine inequalities. So we're going to see how we can do this for fractions. We have 7/10, 2/3. We're going to replace these by fractions having the same denominator. We know we can get that by multiplying 10 times 3, or 3 times 10. So let's put down here 3 times 10. Down here we'll have 10 times 3. And we need to multiply the numerator and denominator by the same number, so this is going to be 3 times 7. And down here, 10 times 2. So this is going to equal 21 over 30. This is going to equal 20 over 30. Now since 21 is greater than 20, this fraction is greater than this fraction. And therefore 7/10 is greater than 2/3, which we could see anyway from the bars. So finding common denominators for two fractions will always show which is the greater fraction. Let's look more closely at what we did to get these fractions with the common denominators. We multiplied the 7 and the 10 by 3 to get 21 over 30. We multiplied the 2 and the 3 by 10 to get 20 over 30. And then we didn't need to look at these denominators, which are the same. We only need to compare the two numerators to see that 7 over 10 was greater than 2 over 3. Now this process can be shortened in the following way. Let's write down our fractions here. 7 over 10, 2 over 3. Now up above we multiplied 7 over 10 both by 3, so we multiply 3 times 7. 3 times 7 and get 21. We multiplied the 2 and the 3 by 10, so all we need to do is multiply 10 times 2. That's going to give us 20. Since 21 is greater than 20, we know this fraction over here is greater than 2/3. Let's use this rule to determine another inequality. In this case, we'll start with 5 over 12. 5 twelfths, 3/7. Then we multiply the denominator of this fraction times this numerator. 3 times 12, 36. We multiply this denominator times this numerator, 35. Now 35 is less than 36. So 5 over 12, 5 twelfths, is less than 3/7. Rules like this are fine to use as long as we have introduced inequality of fractions with illustrations and understanding. Now let's look at mixed numbers. Compare 2 1/4 and 2 3/10. 2 1/4, 2 3/10. Now with mixed numbers, we compare the whole number parts. These are equal, so we need to compare the two fractions. And we can use the test we just developed. 4 times 3 is 12. 1 times 10 is 10. 10 is less than 12. So this mixed number is less than the mixed number on the right. 2 1/4 is less than 2 3/10. Now in rounding mixed numbers, we only need to compare the fraction part to 1/2 when we're rounding to the nearest whole number. This fraction is greater than 1/2. 5 out of 8 parts, 5 is greater than half of the 8 parts. So 2 5/8 is going to round up to 3. This fraction is less than 1/2, so this mixed number is going to round down to 1. This fraction is less than 1/2, so this is going to round down to 0. 4 is greater than half of 7. This fraction is going to round up to 1. Now, when you have 1/2, it's customary to round that up. So 4 1/2 is going to round up to 5. The number line provides more visual support for rounding. Here's a number line that we constructed. Let's put a marker right over here. This 6/12, this is 1/2. And over here, 1 6/12, we could have written these on the number line as 1 1/2. So, rounding to the nearest whole number, 8/12 is closer to the 1 and closer to 0. So 8/12 is going to round to 1. This marker is at the point 1 5/12, and 1 5/12 is closer to 1 than to 2. So 1 5/12 is going to round to 1. In video number 5, in this sequence of 22 videos, we used examples to develop the cross-multiplication rule for determining if two given fractions are equal. And we used common denominators to show why this rule works. The products of denominators times opposite numerators are equal. In this example, 12 times 2 equals 8 times 3. Similarly, in this video, we used common denominators to show why the cross-multiplication rule can be used to determine an inequality for two fractions. In this case, the products of denominators times opposite numerators are not equal. Here we see that 7 times 4 is not equal to 9 times 3. These two rules are very convenient. Students can discover them from patterns, and the rules can be explained by using common denominators. There are two games on fractionbaz.com involving mixed numbers. The first game is Hitting Asteroids, Benchmark Whole Numbers. In Hitting Asteroids, we will select benchmark whole numbers and then the intermediate level. The player is given a mixed number to round to the nearest whole number and clicks the mouse to activate the laser. This player is very good. Up. The second of these two games is called Fraction Dats. In Fraction Dats, we will select the option of one player, a difficulty level of 1, and type the player's name. The height of the dart board is mixed numbers. It goes from 1 4/9 to 4 1/2. The player approximates the location of a balloon, types in a number, clicks throw dart. Nice shot.
Thanks.